waving pink plum tree smells of rotting flesh. Decorated in spices, you approach edible, raw cut against the grain. Walks perimeter, drawing lines with insect poison. One, there are many of them. There are very many of them. Each one is one. Each one is one. There are many of them to name or disregard. Raindrops and flies circling slow. Squashed possum. Car spray. Road smoke. Ghost coasting dreams up trees. The barnyard gone international. Language is a virus. Each one of the animals mutates. Luxuriant spring effervescing. A thick haze of pollen on patio table. Disembark, cast off, begin again. Again, resurrect identity, absorbing the other again. Again, begin, reach, flower, reach. Rhododendron unfolding for the sun as your uncle took his last breath. Robin Blazer disguised himself as a moth. Azalea, crocosmia, daffodil, death, bleeding hearts burst for bees to feed, dreaming stars search for chrysalis in the trees, themselves derivative sorcerers of shadow, creating a canopy of manipulated light, the pure exteriority of language rooted deep within the body. This much is true of everyone. Nothing better to do before bed than make good on commitments. No need to assume morality. The fan here makes like it's ready to fall from the ceiling. Can't I pie twice without things coming to mind? The erasing of individuality for place in the final hall of words, lasting just long enough to evade duration. Our simple eyes see only so far in any direction. The scope of the road signs, visible only to those with good vision from anything less than flashing distance. Something overheard once goes silent until another moment makes everything relevant all over again. Haunted, as you were, all the same. Such awful phrases. Petrified. I've held on to a piece of wood I acquired from Matt Upton on the bus in second grade. Petrified wood. Something holy about it then. Nothing to read into but emptiness. Where is he? What children exchanged hands? I was the fastest at flashcards then. Laughable now. The checkbook in shambles. One finger in the wrong place can ruin the keyboard. All of it. Gone. The random combination of sleep and overuse. The hands veering in and out of breakdown. Like the transmission in the Blazer inching up Sandstone Mountain on the way to pick her up. We packed the Cinderella dress and black tights to stay warm. She stayed the night with her cousin. Birthday party and a play. A photograph of my father between the wicked stepsisters. The first time his happiness has been captured on film in a while. How we watch one another trudge those long miles. Sisyphus returns again and again, awakened each night by his screams of joy, watching the boulder roll. I want to see the ground give way, take back what the companies have done. I want money too if this is what we need in order to survive. I prefer, however, paper that has something past the encryption, a language we can trust and use freely. Clock ticks? Not really, but the phrasing hasn't lost the digital edge yet. But the fan served its purpose, more noise than necessary, reruns you've never seen before. What will this add up to after no one says a word? After thumbs replace the tongue, I will argue the idea of hitchhiking being illegal. More than anything, the rope burns have kept cracked fingers for several days now. A stiffened kind of pain. Beard shaved too short. All of this, a period of healing, of learning to listen to midnight screams and react according to what they say, not what I want. I am the type of person that needs to remind myself of things I should already know. frequently, a maker of lists, many of which never get crossed off. But every thought has led me to the place where other voices are speaking. And this is the last piece I have, and this is for all the people who work in this building and for all the work that has gone unnoticed. In the land I stand on, dead faces whisper facts hidden only by topsoil of company after company, bleeding treasuries from Earth's oldest hills. Union Carbide, Coal and Coke Railroad, Coal and Iron Railroad, Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad, Baltimore and Ohio Railroad, Buffalo Creek and Golly Railroad, Porter's Creek and Golly Railroad. In the land I stand on what is left in the wake of a business that takes its names from what it destroys. Yellow Poplar Lumber Company, Clinch Field Coal Company, Elk River Coal and Lumber Company, Brook Trout Coal Company, Greenbrier River Lumber Company, Patience Incorporated, Hollow Mountain Resources Incorporated. In the land I stand on the throats of breathless workers, and with every step the wind carries their wheezing echo, so that new ears hear the words black lung, silicosis, after damp, black damp, deforestation, acid mine drainage, script, yellow dog, strike. In the land I stand on desecrated homelands and unmarked graves, so I breathe and sing for Buffalo Creek, Matewan, Bloody Mingo, Paint Creek, Cabin Creek, Caford Mountain, Martinsburg, Hawk's Nest, Kanawha, Holly Grove, Blair Mountain, Sago, Alma, Mount Tennis, Semper, Liberi.
Thank you much, Tim.